guys, I'm Yashla and today I'll be showing you how to make a super soft and fluffy eggless vanilla cake plus how to frost it with this beautiful design. So let's get started. First up in our bowl, we're going to add a quarter cup of oil. To that, we're going to add half a cup of curd, or you can add plain yogurt. Give this a good mix until it's all smooth. After it's mixed well, we're going to add half a cup of powdered sugar. Mix this up as well. Now I forgot to film this, but make sure to add half a teaspoon of vanilla essence after mixing this. Now to this we're going to add in 1 cup of all-purpose flour. Now we're going to add in 1 teaspoon of baking powder and half a teaspoon of baking soda. Mix this up until everything is well combined. Now we're going to add in half a cup of milk. Mix this up until the batter is smooth and you don't see any more streaks of flour. And this is how your cake batter should look like. Now you're going to take 2 cake pans. I'm using 2 4-inch cake pans, but you can use any size you have. You're going to first add butter or oil on top of it, and then add a little bit of flour and shake it around so that the flour coats the entire surface. Do this for both of the cake pans. Once you butter and flour both of them, you're going to take your cake batter and divide it equally between the 2 pans. Now you're going to bake this at 190 degrees Celsius for 10 to 15 minutes or until they're nice and golden brown and have risen. Do the toothpick test on both of them, and if the toothpick comes out clean, they're ready. Now let them cool while we prepare the whipped cream. Take half a cup of heavy cream and we're going to whip this until we get stiff peaks. My whipping cream already contains sugar and vanilla in it, but if yours doesn't, you can just add 2 tablespoons of sugar and a splash of vanilla. Whip them until they get stiff peaks, just like this. Once the cakes are fairly cool, it's time to cut the tops off. This gives the cake a flat surface and so it's easy to frost and stack them. Now it's time to frost the cake. Add the layer of simple syrup, which is just some sugar and water. And to that we're going to add our first layer of whipped cream. I'm using a turntable, but if you don't have one, that's okay. You can directly do it on the plate. Make sure to add a pretty thick layer of whipped cream. Now we're going to add the second layer of cake on top and we're going to frost it gently and make a crumb coat. A crumb coat is just a light layer of frosting around the sides so that when we add our main frosting, the crumbs of the cake don't stick to it. After adding the crumb coat, put it in the fridge and then add the main coat on top, and this is how your cake should look like. Now it's time to frost it. I'm going to be doing this really pretty design, but you can frost it however you like. To make this design, you just have to make diagonal lines around the cake, just like so. Make sure to equally space the lines as it gives a neater finish. Now it's time to really make this design come together. You're going to frost from the top of one line to the bottom of the other line, leaving a space in the middle. Just keep repeating that design around the cake. And this is how your cake should look like. Now it's time to add these sprinkles. I'm using these pink heart sprinkles today, but you can use any large sprinkles you have. Just put them on every tip and corner. And now it's time to serve. Okay, so pause. You might be wondering why my cake looks so beat up compared to this before. That's because I forgot to put a cake board on top of my turntable, and so while I was transferring it, the cake fell upside down on the plate. It was really hard to fix as the design was so intricate, and this is the best I could salvage off. But nevertheless, the cake is still super soft and fluffy, and it matches with the lightness of the whipped cream as well. This is a recipe you should definitely try at least once. This week's shout out goes to Arav. Thank you so much for watching my videos. And if you want a shout out, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel and comment. If you liked my video, please like, share and subscribe, as it really motivates me to make more videos. And I'll see you soon. Bye!